أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is your brother in Islam, Shahid Ali, coming to you with our Wednesday night reminder. At the time when we were coming into our masajid, as we all remember, it wasn't too long ago, I used to give a reminder every Wednesday night after Salat al-Maghrib or Salat al-Isha, and we all know of the situation that we're currently in because of the quarantine and preventing ourselves from spreading of the coronavirus, that we're not able to be in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And obviously that hurts everybody, because alhamdulillah, house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a place of blessing and a place of goodness, and we see our fellow brothers and sisters, and alhamdulillah, other people of believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that obviously uplifts us. And so, but if we can't, we're not able to come to our masajid, at least we can still benefit from the reminders that we, inshallah ta'ala, would have listened to. And especially would have is actually the point of the reminder for tonight, as we would have been doing a lot of things right now if it wasn't for the certain situation that we have to stay home. We shouldn't be obviously mixing with too many people. And so there's a lot of good things that people used to do, whether that was visiting family, whether that was participating in your children's school and maybe help with your children's sports team and teaching, or, you know, all these different things that people would be doing if they're able to go out and, you know, roam around and mix with other people. And because of the situation, we're all at home. And so a lot of us are saying, obviously, it's a tough situation. I mean, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us learn from this situation and relieve us from it and give us a cure from this virus. But there's also a lot of lessons in it. But one thing I wanted to focus on is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasized on doing things in a consistent manner, doing things habitually. So you're helping people not just once, but you're there for that person or there for some individuals every week or every month. It's on a consistent basis. Or coming to the masjid, you used to come every time for Maghrib and for Salat al-Isha or at Fajr or wherever the case may be. And obviously now we're not able to do that. So the Prophet ﷺ has something very beautiful in a hadith that he mentioned in Sahih Bukhari and other places, where he says, إِذَا مَرِضَ الْعَبْدِ أَوْ سَاثَرَ كُتِبَ لَهُ مِثْلُ مَا يَعْمَلُ مُقِيمًا صَحِيحًا. The Prophet ﷺ said that if the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes sick, or he is traveling, or if they are traveling, it is written for that person what they used to do when they were healthy and a resident in their hometown. That is still written for them, even though they're sick and they're not able to perform that act, or that if they are traveled and not able to do the good things that they used to do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through his amazing rahmah and mercy, will still write that down for that person. So this shows you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, how important it is to build habitual acts and things we do on a routine basis in terms of goodness, that those individuals who are coming to the masjid normally for Jum'ah, for Salat al-Isha, for Maghrib, for Fajr, for classes, for programs, and you're not able to do so, and that obviously hurts our hearts. We love to get back to staying in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that don't worry, you're still getting reward as if you would be doing that right now. That good consistent act, that good routine that you have had, alhamdulillah, even though it was hard for you to come every night, or had to, you know, leave the house or leave dinner or come to this class or go visit this person and visit your mother or visit your siblings or help your child with it at school, or volunteer for this or volunteer for that. Alhamdulillah, that good effort that you were putting in, you're banking in the reward right now, right? That alhamdulillah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still writing that for you. That, you know, every Monday you used to do that, you still get that reward. Every Wednesday you used to do this, every Friday, every Saturday, whatever the case may be, even though that we're on our houses. So imagine the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and shows how important to build that good reputation or that good routine and schedule of doing good things, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still reward that people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those to do good deeds on a consistent basis. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, you are the Shafi, you're the one who gives cure. Give us a cure for this sickness and protect us from it. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask you to return us back to your house and help us be grateful for what we had in our Islamic centers and amongst our community. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace and blessings on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and his followers until the day of judgment. Akuli qawli hadha astaghfiru wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu ghafurur rahim. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun alal mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Inshallah, take care, stay safe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.